Hey everybody, Robbie here again, and I got Pete Newman, Assistant Chief Pilot, with me as well. We're going to be showing you how to do a simple pickup in a helicopter. We're in one of our newer R-44 Raven 2s, and we're at Parowan Airport in Utah, southern Utah. Super hot day. DAs are around 8,500 feet, so high power settings and stuff today. But winds are calm. Beautiful, gorgeous day. So we're going to go ahead and talk through how we're going to do this maneuver. It's obviously one of our really basic maneuvers, but a really, really important one, simply because there are a lot of helicopter accidents that happen during pickup, during setdown, in close relation to the ground. So these are really, really critical, important things for us to understand and to go through. So the whole purpose here is to get that helicopter up off the ground and into a stabilized 3 to 5 foot hover. And so for us, what we're going to do is we're going to start with doing what we call a waterfall check. Or we're going to check all of our gauges. So if we like to call it a waterfall check because we go from top to bottom through all of our gauges. So on this helicopter, we're going to look at the top, make sure that all the lights are out, and then we're going to go through, make sure that all of our gauges are all in the green, and that we have plenty of fuel for the flight that we're doing. And so down through that waterfall check, everything looks good right now for this aircraft to move forward. Then we're going to make sure that our cyclic is centered and our pedals are neutral. We don't want any pitch in that tail rotor, and make sure that we're nice and flat with that main rotor, with that right hand on the cyclic. And then we're going to get our eyes outside. A natural tendency of people is to look at the ground right in front of the helicopter, but it really, really helps if we can look out at the horizon or something a couple hundred feet out in front of you. That'll just really help you to not over-control the aircraft as we are picking up off the ground. And then we're going to start raising the collective really slowly until we get light on the skids. And you'll know your aircraft, you'll start understanding at what power setting for the type of DAs and things that you have that you get light on the skids, so you'll kind of know. But really it's a feel thing, so we're just slowly raising. Pete's there, just slowly raising on that collective to kind of feel when we're getting light. And right about there, we're pulling about 15, just a little less than 16 inches of manifold pressure, and that's where we're getting a little bit light today. And then we're going to pause, and we're just going to make sure that nothing feels like it's trying to move in any other direction, that everything's just still neutral. And then we're going to continue raising, and we're going to maintain our ground position using our cyclic, and we're going to maintain our heading using our pedals as we slowly pick up. Now we should, in an R-44 normally, you'll see a right skid pick up first and then a left skid. So as Pete lifts up here, there's a right skid and then a left skid, and those all happen at the same time. So we're using our pedals, our cyclic, and our collective all at the same time to just slowly pick up off the ground. Now at any time, if we felt that a skid was stuck or we start sliding around on the ground or anything, all we're going to do is lower that collective back down to the ground, and we'll set right back down, we'll reset ourselves, and we'll make another attempt. And then we just get into this 3 to 5 foot hover, which we are at right now. And that is essentially your pickup. Now, what we're going to note, a couple of things. We like to look and see what our power setting is at in a hover, because there's several other maneuvers where we want to know that number. So right now, we're looking at about 20 inches for our IG hover. And then just so that you know, for this maneuver, as far as the ACS standards go for your check rides, your heading as you're performing that pickup needs to be plus or minus 10 degrees. That's both for private and for commercial. And then we're also going to have an altitude in this hover, plus or minus 2 feet. And then for that touchdown, we got to be plus or minus 4 feet for private standards, plus or minus 2 feet for commercial standards. The biggest thing that I really want to point out with this maneuver is making sure that you're really focused on the maneuver. Sometimes people just quickly just go to pick up the helicopter thinking about the flight ahead. They're not quite warmed up, they're not centered in the helicopter yet. You got to be focused on that pickup. Like I said before, a lot of accidents happen during pickup, so we want to be really, really cognizant and 100% focused on what we're doing with the aircraft as we pick up into that hover. But that is how you pick up a hover. Great job, Pete.
Thank you.
Great pickup. that's how you do it, and we will see you next time.